Hi everybody, I'm Jeff from Missouri Wind and Solar, and I'm up here in Michigan, and I'm with Dennis Peet. He'll be in a minute, and I want to show you a new solar tracker that's been designed and patented by Dennis, and it's called a solar time tracker. It doesn't work by following the sun, it works on time. And this is a patented device, and Dennis just got this done. Okay, this is Dennis Peet, and he is the designer of the solar time tracker, and he holds the patent on it. So, Dennis, why don't you explain what the solar time tracker is?
Well, the solar time tracker, it goes by the time of day. It's just like a watch, so it moves just like by the time. So if it's 8 o'clock, it will move at the 8 o'clock position. But normally what they do, they'll be at east. And as the day goes on, when the sun rotates, moves, it will stop at where the sun's at. So it will move every hour through the day until it gets west. And at 10 o'clock at night, the solar tracker, or solar time tracker, will say, hey, time to go back home. So it will go back home, which is east, and wait for the sun to come up again.
Yeah.
And what's good about the solar time tracker is you don't have all the, the tracker, solar trackers, is you don't have all the electronics on your pole sticking up into the eye, especially if you live in a place where you got a lot of snow covering up the eye. And so it's all you have is just an actuator out here that turns it. The rest of it's in a box. It's got two processors in it, or one processor for one pole. It's got two processors for two poles. So everything's all in the box. It's in the building. You don't have to worry about the weather. And it's always going to track the sun, no matter what. You don't have to worry about clouds or chasing a cloud or something. It just works by the time of day.
Oh, okay. So the solar tracker, solar time tracker, works by time of day. It moves by time.
Right.
The solar tracker follows the sun.
Right.
Which I think the time tracker makes a lot more sense.
Right.
Especially on cloudy and real hazy days.
Right.
It's not looking for the sun at all.
Yeah.
It's going to be pointing at the sun no matter what time of day it is.
It always knows where the sun's at. It ain't chasing something, a white cloud. It always knows where that sun is at a certain time of day.
So this is the actuator on the 12-panel mount. Dennis can explain about this actuator.
And this actuator is made in the United States. It's a very heavy built actuator. This is a 36-volt motor on it. You also can run a 24-volt motor if you want. Anyways, it's very well built.
This the one with steel gears?
Yeah, it also has a steel gears in this one. A lot of them's got plastic gears in them. Like I said, this one here is all metal.
Made in the U.S.
Made in the U.S., yeah.
Okay. And the good thing about this is this actuator is going to hold up for a lot longer than a regular solar tracker, because the solar tracker is constantly moving.
Right.
And
This only has just four wires that hook into it. You got two limit switches in here, so when it extends all the way out, it hits a limit switch so you don't overhit the stroke. And when it comes in, also got a limit switch so you don't damage anything in it. So just four wires, that's all it takes to run this out here. You don't have electronics out here.
And this is the 12-panel mount, isn't it?
Right.
You can pan over all of this if you want to, Adam, and show the whole thing. I don't know if you can. There's locks and stuff on that pan.
This is a grid tie solar. They're 235-watt panels. And they got microinverters on them, which changes the DC to AC to 240.
So these M-phase grid tie inverters?
Yeah.
Okay, yeah. Yeah, we've installed a bunch of those, which is really easy to
You can
to
tell
install.
When you're making power, they'll start blinking up here. Tells you that your solar panels are making power.
Oh, yeah. You see the blinking light on this one?
Yeah.
Wow, these are really well built. And this is a 6-inch pipe.
Yeah, it's Schedule 40.
A Schedule 40 6-inch pipe.
It's also made so you can tilt the solar panels, because since I live here in Michigan, you got to, the winter months, you want to tilt it to 40 degrees Normally in October is when you want to start that, and April is when you want to turn it back up to 30 degrees because the sun's higher.
Ah, okay. All right, now you notice the base on this, it's all bolted down. The pipe isn't buried in concrete like all of them I've seen. If you move, you can unbolt this and take this whole tracker with you.
Also, what's nice about each one of these panels weigh about 40 pounds. So it's a lot better when they're on a pole. I can clean the snow off and just take a brush and wipe the snow off. Where I'm at, if I had these on the roof, I'd be up in 2 foot of snow trying to clean the snow off these panels. So
big advantage when you're in a snow area with having a solar tracker over having them on your roof.
Right.
I know that for myself where we live. It's very easy to clean off our rack outdoors that's on the ground.
Right.
And these would be very easy to clean off.
Yeah. Well, my wife comes out and cleans them, so I don't even have to worry. If it was on the roof, I'd be up there cleaning them. So.
Excellent. Now, this 12-panel rack, Dennis has this all set up. These are Enphase grid tie inverters. And these things are so simple, you can install them yourself. There's nothing to it. So you notice these trunk lines? Each inverter just plugs into the trunk line, and your solar panel plugs into the inverter. It's pretty simple. All of these trunk lines just tie into this cable, and it comes down to a 30-amp breaker. And from here, it just goes into the house, into the service panel, into another 30-amp breaker, Dennis?
Right.
That's how easy it is with these Enphase grid tie inverters. Just a 30-amp breaker in your fuse box, and this just plugs right into it, wires right into that breaker. Now I'll go show you the 8-panel battery jab. This is the 8-panel tracker, and this has a 4-inch pipe to it. I'll show you what this looks on the backside. Now this one is for your battery charging.
Right, this is battery.
This one's set up for battery charging. We're running them through a test right now. It's a test scan.
Yeah. He's moving them east right now, and then they're going to run through a test scan.
That moves really smooth.
Now listen, listen.
I'm going to go in here to the 8-foot. Okay, it's 11 o'clock in the morning, and you can watch the meter turn backwards. And you got electric heat in the house, Danny?
Yeah, electric heat.
Dennis?
I've got a geothermal furnace, so it's all electric.
So you have geothermal furnace. Yeah, okay. That's really spinning the meter backwards pretty fast. You're doing it with those two trackers.
My electric bill, like $15. I went from $140 to $15.
All right, so you got a $15 a month electric bill from $140. Well, that's not going to take real long for it to pay for itself.
Central air, too, so, yeah, it's really helped us a lot.
And central air. Oh, Ren Dennis's shop, and this is the solar time tracker controller. This is for the dual, if you're going to have two solar trackers. And this is for the single, if you're going to have just a single tracker out there. It's a pretty well-built little unit, too. And it's pretty simple. Dennis can explain how this works. You want me to open the door on it?
Well, first thing we'll talk about, there's actuators out there. I got two solar panel poles out there. One's an 8-panel pole, one's a 12-panel pole. So this one is my 12-panel. This is my 8-panel pole. Okay, all it is four wires that hook up to your actuator out there. You got two of them over here, that's for your motor, and two here for your limit switches. That's all you have to do is hook it up. And this is my 8 panel. This is my 8 panel. There's my motor and my limit switches. This is an option you can get. It's a tilt, so you can manually by hitting these buttons here, you can tilt the actuator for winter and summer months. So like in April, you know, you'd set it at summer, so you want to set it at 30 degrees. In October, you want to go winter, so you want to set it at 40 degrees. So by hitting this button, you can adjust your solar panel, tilt it. Or you can do it manually, too. Just go out there and loosen your bolts up and turn your solar panel.
Tilt it, yeah.
But anyways, to operate this is very simple. What I want to do is hold this button until it says zero. The actuator will be extended all the way out. And then after it's all extended all the way out, I would hit this button. This is just my 12 panel one. So this is, I'd hold this button in for 3 seconds. And then it will say zero. And then that's it. I don't have to do any more. It's all done. The thing will run it by itself. It knows exactly where to go. That when the hour comes up, if it's, especially if it's 8 o'clock in the morning or 10 o'clock in the morning or 1 o'clock in the afternoon, and you set this thing up, just leave it pointed east, and this thing, as soon as 1 o'clock in the afternoon comes up, this thing will know where it's supposed to be at, so it will move your solar panels. Very simple. And also, you have a test button. After you're aimed east, you've got your solar panel aiming east, you have a test button also. This will also, if you hold it in for 7 seconds, and all of a sudden these panels will go through a test, so every hour, this thing will move and stop for 30 seconds, move and stop for 30 seconds until it gets west, and then it will go all the way back home.
Okay, the way this works, you have to have an outlet for the power supply. I'll show you the top. Now, this is for the single tracker. That's pretty easy, and that's for the actuator motor. And the motor, and that's for the switch and the switch.
East and west. Yeah.
Okay.
And this one here is just for your tilt. That's an option that you can get with it if you want to. Let's say you want to manually, or so you don't have to go out there and loosen any bolts up to tilt it. You can do it here by adding that to it.
So it's a single axis, and then you can get a dual axis. Okay.
We checked and see how much power these use, and they use less than $1 a year just to operate these.
Really?
Yep.
Well, that's nothing. Less than $1 a year to operate this box. So.
Yeah.
Now, the 8-foot tracker requires 3-foot deep by 3-foot square base. And the 12-panel tracker requires a 4-foot deep by 4-foot square concrete base. I'm going to be installing an 8-panel solar time tracker at the store, so I'll be doing a video on that here pretty soon. So I'm Jeff from Missouri Wind and Solar, and I'll see you on my next video.